Commercial real estate and oil and gas, and really real estate in general, are very similar from an investor standpoint. One, you as an investor, you're looking for a passive investment that can yield you a return. So when you're looking in real estate, you're typically looking for projects that have location, they have good quality, and that they provide a good, consistent cash flow. Oil and gas is really no difference. The one key component is really the cash flow, which I'll touch on here in a second. But we all understand that location, 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 right? The same in oil and gas. You want to be in the right areas, you want to be in fields that produce, and there's a lot of data to collect to identify that location. So location is critical in both investment vehicles. Now, quality. Depending on what type of real estate you're doing, if you're just a passive investor, you know, it's nicer to invest in a Class A than a Class C, you know, or a mobile home park that is small or a large one. You as an investor have to determine the quality of who you're doing business with and the quality of the investment. Same thing in oil and gas. It matters who you're doing business with. Drilling and completing and operating, it matters the track record and the history and the quality of the operation. Now, on the cash flow side, this is where things get a little different. From a cash flow perspective in real estate, it's a little bit more tangible, right? You have a location, you need a renter, which is your cash flow stream. And you can quantify that, and you can see that, and you know that the different market and the different timing and how many people are driving by the location, all of that stuff helps you as a investor look at the risk to reward. Now, on the oil and gas side, we're drilling into the ground. So there's not a guarantee that there's gonna be something there. Now, modern day technology has allowed for a lot of ways to de-risk that. You have seismic amplitudes, you have different types of pieces of information that help the oil and gas teams decide if there's gonna be cash flow. But again, the risk is still there, that something's gonna be in there or how much of it is actually there. Those are your differences. Now, what the IRS does is the IRS gives a major tax benefit to oil and gas investors. Those benefits allow you to offset your investment over, you know, over the first year, which is what we call an intangible drilling cost. This allows you to offset that risk, okay? You can look for more information about this. On the real estate side, you get depreciation and amortization usually over 25 years. So when you look at the investments, they are very similar. Don't get so lost in all of the details. I want you to know on our platform, that information is there and it's available. But from an investor standpoint, real estate and oil and gas are very similar.